Yesterday, the Young Turks had a special guest, Charlamagne Tha God, who's generated a lot of headlines with some of his criticism of Joe Biden. Join the show. And on that, they talked about the stakes for the upcoming debate, and in particular, what the stakes are for Joe Biden if it were to go poorly for him. Take a look.
If he does flop so hard that it's even the media can't deny it, should they pull him?
I would say yes. The reason I would say yes is because you know the base is gonna show up, and but it's about like those independents and those hypothetical swing voters, those people who you know maybe undecided. You know, it's about them. Like those are the ones that I think are really gonna you know change the tide of the election. You know, come November.
So look, he has his perspective. Obviously, he's been critical of Joe Biden, but he's also repeatedly said how much worse for our country, for democracy, Donald Trump would be. It's a nuanced take that he's had, not only in that clip, but overall, that's often lost in some of the like the view-esque talk about him. But I do think that it's an interesting point in that we don't generally get a debate this early in the process. And coupled with the fact that the conventions are a little bit later, we do have this sort of unique opportunity wherein if it were to go really poorly, and if that were to tank the numbers for Joe Biden, there would be a potential out. And it's an out that a lot of people have speculated about for some time. So Adrienne, I'm curious what you think about that. If it goes really badly, if the numbers really shift, do you think that makes any difference in what happens at the DNC?
Unfortunately, I don't. I think that people are so locked into having Joe Biden in terms of those in positions of power at the DNC that they are going to cut off their nose to spite their faces to continue to move forward with him. I think it should make the world of difference because you know we've seen him perform. The thing is that Joe Biden is not as smooth as he used to be. He does not come off as quick. So as much as he can do the job, the question is, should he do the job and would he honestly survive the job? And it's the same thing with regard to Trump, but it's just more in your face when it comes to Joe Biden. And I think that if we did actually have an actual two-party system, which we shouldn't even have in theory, but if we actually did have an operating system, Biden would never even have been on the ticket to begin with, that they would have elevated someone else.
Yeah. Yeah, look, I still don't think that it's very likely. I am assuming that there's probably some pressure campaigns from some of the like Democratic governors that would like to replace him, but they can't be seen to be too aggressive, or that could potentially backfire as well. So I don't know how likely it is to happen, although I think it is perhaps it's one of the like if there was going to be something that inspired it to happen, this is probably the most likely thing that could potentially do that. In the same way that you know, on the 11th, 3 days before the RNC, Donald Trump being sent to prison would be the best chance of them replacing with the RNC, although that probably isn't that likely either. And both sides of that, by the way, are ridiculous that we're in this position. But that said, I wanna play a little bit more from the interview because Charlamagne had some advice for both Biden and Trump of what they should do going into this debate.
You know, it's all of this talk going around about, you know, Biden needing to be drug tested and, you know, they want to check them for PEDs. If they got PEDs to give them, give it to them. I'm all for the drugs. Drug them up. Like give him the same super serum they gave Steve Rogers to make him Captain America. Expose him to the same gamma radiation Bruce Banner got exposed to become the Incredible Hulk. I want him to join a long list of incredible athletes who were better when they were on PEDs. The Mark McGuire's, the Barry Bonds of the world. If they got something that can make him look more energetic on Thursday, that can make him look like he's not in cognitive decline, they need to give it to him. And by the way, Trump definitely needs to take some too. So I'm like, yo, man, everybody need to stop trying to, you know, call each other out for possibly using performance enhancing drugs. And both of them need to get on performance enhancing drugs and may the best prescription win on Thursday.
I love the way that he closed that out. We had a comment from Gary Cooper, a member on YouTube, says TV debates aren't the Olympic Games. If there really is a drug that makes Biden win debates, shouldn't he be taking it? Shouldn't Trump take it too? And that was before we played that clip. Actually, Gary Cooper, let's return to that for a Blue Apron gift card during the break. But look, I would say if there is something they can take, they're definitely both taking it. The stakes are so high. Also, if there is something that can actually help them in terms of their cognition, they shouldn't just take it for the debate. You're the president. Maybe just take those like regularly. Maybe all of our politicians should be taking things that make them think more clearly. But the difference is, and my fear in him even joking about that is that that's a thing that the right has already been saying a lot. And so I think there's a lot of people that will take it seriously. I think that they both could benefit from some sort of performance enhancing drugs, but I think the difference is which drug they need. Joe Biden needs espresso. He needs a double or triple shot to boost him up, and maybe he'll burn out by the end of it or whatever, but that's what he needs.
John, his heart might burn out. Like, that's what I'm thinking about all these drugs. These men can't handle this stuff. They probably can't even handle the little blue pill. We can't be just hopping them up on giving them anything. Like, if anything, we need to give him a good night's rest.
Yeah, I don't know what you give Trump to help him focus, to stay on message. What drug cures shark electrocution brain?
He needs an exorcism. Okay, I don't know what to tell you about Trump. There's nothing that's going to fix that problem. I'm concerned about hopping all these people up on Adderall and all these other things because I don't know that their hearts could take it, and we just be in another situation where we have to put someone else in office. I'm not trying to drug up a president.
Their hearts might not be able to take it. But that is a risk I'm willing to take. When you click the join button and become a tier 2 member, you get access to all of our weekly top 10 lists. What are you waiting for?